Hi all, this video is in continuation with the blog. Those of you who have not read the blog yet, please find the link in the description. In this video, we will focus on how the group maintenance table works in the background whenever a user requests access to a record. In the scenario being explained, we have the role hierarchy as shown. As you can see, we have the two roles, East Sales Rep and West Sales Rep, at the same level under the Sales Executive. As mentioned in the blog, we have the sharing rule on account that shares read access to the records owned by each role to each other, which means East Rep users will have access to accounts created by West Sales Rep users and vice versa. As shown, we have the following users assigned. Setting up the roles will trigger Salesforce to set up the group maintenance table. From the blog, we know that membership data is stored on groups that can be system defined and user defined. Here in this case, for this role hierarchy, a system defined group is used with the group name same as the role name. For this setup, a group maintenance table is created as shown. From this table, you can see there are two rows for both roles. In both group, since the OWD setup grants access to users up in the role hierarchy, Lucas is also added to both the group. Now let's see in detail what happens when the role hierarchy is set up. So, the role hierarchy setup creates this group maintenance table. You can see Clara is part of each sales rep and her managers Lucas and Rose are also part of the same group via the grant access using role hierarchy OWD setting. I've just added some key points related to group maintenance table for your reading. Let's see how Salesforce stores account object. The entire setup has the account, account share table, and the group maintenance table. Focusing on the account and account share table, we see a record for our scenario. The record A1 owned by Irwin in the account table, and the records that give access to Irwin being an owner, and second record that gives access to East Sales Rep role via the sharing rule in the account share table. Clara, another sales rep from the East Sales Group, would like to access the account A1 created by Irwin from the West Sales Group. Let's see how Salesforce provides the access. When Clara requests access for the record by providing the record ID A1, Salesforce checks in the account table and finds the record. Once a match is found, it checks in the account share table by matching the same ID and finds a record that gives access to East Sales Group. Now, Salesforce needs to look if Clara is a part of the group, and as mentioned earlier, Salesforce has already updated the group maintenance table. It's just a matter of finding if Clara is in there. Salesforce matches the group maintenance table with the group name and finds the users in the group. In this case, Clara is present in the table, so Salesforce provides the intended access. Clara now can access the account A1 thanks to Salesforce. This scenario provides a glimpse into the complex data processing and calculations that occur behind the scene in Salesforce to support its robust record access mechanism. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.